In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole empire had to be registered.
The first registration took place while Quirinius was governing Syria.
So everyone went to be registered, each to his own town.
And Joseph went up from the town of Galilee in Judah to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because it was from the line and family of David.
To be registered along with Mary, who was engaged to him and was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth.
Then she gave birth to her firstborn son, and she wrapped him snugly in cloth and laid him in a feeding trough, because there was no room for them at the lodging place.
In the same region, shepherds were staying out in the fields and keeping watch at night over their flock.
And the angels of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and then they were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all people.
Today, a Savior who is Messiah the Lord is born for you in the city of David.
This will be a sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in cloth and lying in a feeding trough."
Suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heavens and peace on earth to people he favors."
When the angels had left them and returned to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go straight to Bethlehem and see what has happened, which the Lord has made known to us."
They hurried off and found both Mary, Joseph, and the baby who was lying in the feeding trough.
After seeing them, they reported the message they were told about this child.
And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary was treasuring up to these things in her heart and meditating on them.
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard, just what they had been told.
That day began just like any other day. I woke up early and was strolling through the field to take my turn watching the sheep. Okay. I had intended to get up early, but as usual, things weren't going quite like I'd planned. I know. It's hard to believe, but I wasn't always the polished, respected shepherd I am today.
Oops, sorry, I'm just running a little late. There sure are a lot of people traveling today.
It's the census. We all have to be counted by decree Caesar Augustus. I'm Joanna, and this is my little sister Simone.
Wanna stay and play with us?
Sorry, I need to go watch my sheep. Nice to meet you. Gotta go!
What I didn't know was that that day had set into motion events that would change the course of my life and of history.
Today could be the day we see a miracle.
A savior in our time could be a miracle.
Expectations in the air, could the Messiah be near?
We are waiting. We are waiting for a miracle.
Yeah.
don't see how many room at this inn.
Where's Nathaniel? He's late again. His shift was supposed to start, when the sun was there. And now the sun's over there.
Don't be so hard on him, Abigail. You know he gets distracted. Besides, I like having a break. I think it's peaceful being out in the fields. Besides, there's enough to do helping Mom at home. I can sit back, put my feet up, and...
Those are my sisters and my older brother. Everyone in the family helps out in the pasture. They're on the early morning shift.
Oh, there you are, Nathaniel. How's the trip through town?
Better than the latest trip over the sheep.
I heard people have been arriving by the hundreds, more people than I've ever seen.
I tripped over some nice kids, Joanna and Simone. They're here for the census, but on to more important things, the sheep. How's Max's foot? Has Beatrice been getting enough exercise? I promised JoJo I would help him stretch out his left hind foot. He injured it last week in our self-defense class.
They're sheep, Nathaniel. Seriously, you talk about them like they're your friends.
What? They're just sheep, Abigail. Don't be crazy. What kind of person would be friends with sheep?
I was friends with the sheep. I had the greatest adventures with them. For me, it was all about those sheep.
Have fun with your friends, Nate. We'll be back when the sun goes down.
I had a peaceful, easy feeling with my sheep. I mean, I knew they couldn't actually talk, but when I looked in their eyes, it was like I could almost hear what they were thinking.
I know what you're thinking, that it's not a possibility. A sheep could be talking or telling his story.
Ba, ba, boo, boo. Ba, ba, boo, boo.
Sheep were sorted in, so the chance of having any opinion is slim. He's a little goofy, but give him a shot.
Max, how's it going? What's on your mind? You can't wait to get a haircut? Great idea, buddy.
We talk about sheep stuff. Sheep stuff.
Before I knew it, my shift was over, and I was running back through town thinking about the great meal I would have.
Whoa, running shepherd alert! You really don't stand still for very long, do you?
Nathaniel, can we go on an adventure with you? I'm bored.
Well, I'm just heading home for supper.
Oh, we have some leftover food if you'd like some. We're staying right here in the inn. Actually, we're lucky to get a room. The innkeeper told Papa this is the busiest he's ever seen in years.
Well,
I guess I could eat with you and then take you to see my sheep.
Sheep, sheep, see the sheep.
She's just trying to avoid going to bed.
Simone eventually convinced me, and soon we were walking back to the fields under a deep, dark blanket of night.
You're gonna love my flock. Now, Beatrice, she's the feisty one. But then there's Max. He's so cool, all the other foes lead. And then there's JoJo. He's just so funny.
I could talk about my sheep all day, but little did I know something unbelievable would happen that night.
Style. A straightener would add a few inches and could really elongate my midriff.
Beatrice, are you talking about that botched hairstyle you tried last season? It looked like you had been hit by lightning.
It's kind of crimping iron, boys, and it was totally on fleece.
On fleece?
It's the latest lingo. I'm told it'll catch on soon. But anyways, crimp was in fashion in the fall. Ask anyone, and that crimper had 5 stars on the Amazon. As for the wool treatment, I had mud imported in the pasture at Lambton Abbey. If Cece hadn't let the mud in so long, I could have been the top fashionista in the field.
You were certainly the dirtiest. It was bad.
It was supposed to evaporate. The wool was supposed... that's not me, Max.
Sorry, I had my U-plugs in. What's happening?
What is Let's try a new technique. Last week in sheep defense class, I learned the sheep knitter. Everybody, hold close and move as one. Left, right, left.
I feel silly.
This seems like just swaying. What's this supposed to do?
I heard you scared away predators.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Sing glory. Glory to God. Glory.
That can't be right.
You will find a baby boy, and this will be the sign.
Gloria.
Wrapped up in a stable stall, the savior of mankind.
Gloria. Today. Yeah.
We could barely contain our shock and excitement in what the angels had told us. Had the Messiah really been born? And why would the angels choose to tell shepherds? As I've said before, I was not always the popular public figure I am today. And yet we could not ignore what we had seen or heard.
Did it work? Are they gone?
Yep, they're gone.
Yes, the sheep and air worked.
That's your takeaway from this?
Those were angels, JoJo. We just witnessed something extraordinary.
We're gotta go see this baby, right?
I don't know. Sounds like a risky journey.
After seeing that, I don't think we can stay here. Plus, I bet our main man Nathaniel will want to go. We'll stick with him.
Are your sheep okay? They haven't moved in a while.
Hey, little buddies. Everything all right? Max, Beatrice, Cece, JoJo?
Bye.
Bye.
They were just scared. Don't worry, guys. You're safe and sound.
Did we really just see that?
I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it for myself.
Were those real angels, or am I just having a seriously weird dream?
They were definitely angels. But what was even more unbelievable was their announcement that the Messiah was to be born as a baby.
But we always thought he would come with great power.
Yes, everyone knows Messiah has arrived.
Definitely. The prophets say he'll bring a new kingdom.
But the angel said the Messiah is a baby. Could that be true? What if he isn't supposed to lead a battle here on Earth? Could it be all about that baby?
That God never planned to send a savior and a conquering king. Could it be, oh, could it be what we've been waiting for? Our expectations were wishes and dreams.
Could he be, oh, could he be?
If it's all about that baby, we gotta go see him. What are we waiting for?
Let's think this through. Do we really know what we saw?
I don't know. I know I was feeling pretty hungry. Maybe we imagined it.
People would think we're crazy if we go around town talking about angels.
But we have to tell people. The angels entrusted the good news to us.
Listen, Nathaniel, people already think you're nuts, but I still have a chance.
It's true. They do call you the boy who talks to sheep.
I'm out. I gotta go get something to eat.
I'll go with you.
Well, I am in. We have to go tell people about this baby.
I'm in too. This is the most exciting thing that's ever happened.
I'm the boy who talks to sheep. We've got to go see this baby.
Right now, the shiny guy said, a king. I cannot go see a king without at least a wool blowout. That should take maybe clothes on if I start right now. Cece, get my crimper.
Again with the wool do. Have you learned nothing?
Well, I'm smart enough to know you don't go see king. I'm at least a little preparation.
Something's happening to Nathaniel.
Abigail's right. I'm already a laughing stock in town. Plus, I've got to take care of the sheep. Beatrice hasn't been looking very well.
Not looking well? Well, that's the last time I defend you, buddy. I'll have you know I have not been getting my usual 10 hours of sleep. I've been getting 9. And you know what 9 hours of sleep can do to a sheep's body. I'm running under impossible conditions here, and if you think...
What is going on with your sheep?
Bah, 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 bah.
It's okay, old girl.
Bah?
For once, I was going to follow some good advice. I would stay in the fields and take care of my ailing sheep. I was always too impulsive, and I needed to be responsible. The baby could wait. What we didn't know was that far off in the east, wise men had seen a star and wondered what it could mean.
Expensive treasures we can find.
A star in the sky like I've never seen before. Do you see it? A star like I've never seen before. Must mean a miracle. A miracle is waiting for the world.
A star in the sky like I've never seen before.
like I've never seen before. A star in the sky like I've never seen before.
Must be no miracle. A miracle is waiting for the world.
Must mean a miracle. A miracle is waiting for the world.
I don't care if these humans have gone crazy. Some glowing angel beings have appeared to all of us, so we are going to see what they were talking about. It's decided. We are going to see that baby.
Yay!
Nathaniel thinks he should stay here. How can we convince him?
We could try a sheep in here again.
I don't think so, JoJo. Let's try to communicate with Nathaniel. Sometimes I think he can almost understand us.
What if he doesn't?
Then we'll go with Plan B. But let me try first. Nathaniel, I really think we should go see the king like the baby said. It could be one of the greatest moments in history. I don't want you to miss out on.
Love you too, buddy.
Plan B then.
Plan B. When I give the signal, take off running in the directions the angel said to go. But only if I give the signal. I'll shout, find the baby!
Let's try it one more time, all together this time.
Be my guest.
Hold up!
Why are they all staring at you?
No offense, but your sheep are kind of freaking me out.
And suddenly, the strangest sound came out of Max.
Baby!
Amazingly, it seemed that my favorite sheep had known to do what I did not. They went to find the baby, and so we followed.
Whoa, Max, Beatrice, I think we're here.
Where the angels told us the baby king would be.
Is this the baby?
The Messiah.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. This silent night, the stars are brightly shining. Born, for unto us a son is given. The government will be around his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Thank you.
of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever.
That night, the Savior of the world was born in a stable, and we were the first ones to see him. Sometime later, the wise men would arrive after their long journey, but we never forgot the chance to be among the first ones to know about God's precious gift.
In the bleak midwinter,
so you see, it was really a night to remember, a night that changed the course of history. Hope was born into a world that desperately needed it. Aw, guys, I wish you could understand what happened. It changed everything.
He will save us, he will conquer those who cry. He will free us, he has
That night, Jesus was born and my life was forever changed. I'm ready to tell the world it's all about that baby.